XFM News. On point.
Guys, here's a quick look at the news. I'm Lynn Komjisha. The Ministry of Health has asked nurses and midwives to call off their planned strike. On Sunday, Nurses and Midwives Union issued an ultimatum of 31st December for the government to increase their lunch allowances from 2,000 shillings to 10,000 shillings. State Minister for Health in charge of primary health care, Joyce Kaduchu, says the nurses have valid concerns and the relevant authorities are looking into their matters. She adds that the strike will compromise delivery of services at health facilities.
We are discussing with them. The issue has been put to the relevant authority. Discussions are ongoing to see how best they can be supported in their work. I think they have raised genuine reasons, but as health professions, our method of work is not through putting our tools down. Our method of work is through dialogue. We talk about it. They have raised very genuine issues. How do we talk about it together and ensure that what they are asking is given to them at appropriate time, or we come to an agreement such that they don't put their tools down? Strike is not what we embrace as healthcare professionals.
Meanwhile, Dr. Kaduchu has expressed concern over the low allocations from the national budget that affects the Ministry of Health activities.
The last financial year, the percentage of resource allocation to the sector stood at 7.2, which is still way back to the target of 15%. So that means that the resource envelope allocation to the sector is still not adequate. However, we still continue to prioritize according to the needs of the people, according to the disease burden. Number three, the human resource. The human resource still is not very adequate. Realize most of the facilities may not have 100% the staffing level that we wish to see.
The presidential advisor on epidemics, Dr. Monica Musenero Musanza, has called for the review of the PPD Act to incorporate the aspect of quick response in epidemics. Musenero says the delayed procurement processes during epidemics have frustrated many researchers who would respond to epidemics. She says the current PPD Act is putting the country at risk when it comes to responding to emergencies.
Now, when you're dealing with an epidemic, you need to get what you need like yesterday, because an epidemic, by its definition, is something which is moving very fast. And procurement or research can actually frustrate the research and render it irrelevant. Our researchers were capable of coming up with, for example, candidate vaccine in a matter of months, but that is if they have the equipment. But the fact that government approved and even provided funds for this, it's the procurement process. Processes are very, very frustrating. In fact, nobody knows how to disentangle us, I can tell you.
In sports news, Uganda under-20 football team captain Gavin Chizito Mugweri has called upon his teammates to remain focused despite achieving qualification for the under-20 AFCON tournament. The Hippos sealed the qualification for the tournament scheduled for 2021 in Mauritania yesterday after they convincingly defeated Kenya 3-1 in the Zondo qualifiers semifinals at the Black Rhino Academy Sports Stadium in Karatu, Tanzania. Kenneth Semakula scored the Hippos' opening goal before Ivan Bogere took his tally in the tournament to 4 goals after bagging a brace. According to Mugweri, qualification for the AFCON under-20 finals is part of the objective and that the team should stay focused if they are to go on and win the regional title. Uganda will lock horns with host Tanzania tomorrow in the final.
God has helped us, we are qualified for the AFCON, and I'm quite sure that we're going to really work very hard and we see that we can also win the cup and take it back to Uganda.
In other news, Kenya is now looking to the East for a potential COVID-19 vaccine, according to President Uhuru Kenyatta. The president gave the Ministry of Health the go-ahead to shop for vaccines from China. The country's decision comes in the wake of rich countries in the West buying nearly 3.8 billion doses of vaccines currently in development. COVID-19 seems to be making a comeback with a vengeance, and for us in Kenya, the cases in the counties seem to be growing. This is the Health Minister Mutahi Kagwe saying. Logistics is a major concern when considering access to vaccines. China's President Xi Jinping in May promised the successful vaccines being tested will be offered to Africa at a discounted price. Experts have argued that this offers a potential route to cool off the resentment and criticism that China received on how it handled the pandemic earlier on. Kenya is currently testing the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine of the four countries taking part in vaccine trials. Egypt and Morocco are testing one of the vaccines from China. The Chinese Center for Disease Control and Prevention says the country has five vaccines that have entered phase three clinical trials. However, Kenya has not released much data on the efficacy of its homegrown vaccines. There are now more than 80,000 people who've been confirmed COVID-19 positive in Kenya. More than 1,400 have died from the disease. And that was the news.